Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's May 25th. We're here at
the umpires for this afternoon's game on the base paths. Richie Garcia and behind home plate, Steve Palermo.
The ghost of Steve Palermo is behind home plate. Charlie Russell for Concord TV here. That was our field announcer, Steve, a longtime field announcer and hockey PR man. Steve Potosak. So we're here today for first place Portsmouth, who up until a few days ago was undefeated, and they lost to Timberlane, who's probably not going to make the playoffs. And Concord is, I think, 12-4. They have two more games today against Portsmouth, and then they'll be playing tomorrow night, the 26th. The senior night, they'll be playing Exeter. We'll be here for both games. Concord is in a fight for fourth place, looking to grab a second round home game. Right now, Portsmouth is 16-1. Pinkerton, I think, has lost three games. Concord has lost four or five. Londonderry. So Concord, Londonderry, Exeter, and Winnicott are fighting for that fourth spot. There'll be 14 making the playoffs. First two teams get byes. So it looks like that'll be Portsmouth and Pinkerton. Nate Craig will be pitching today. Last time we were here, he pitched a no-hitter against Manchester Memorial. So he's got a little more formidable opponent here. Memorial was quite a ways down the standings. They were just down outside the... fighting for maybe one of the last playoff spots. So we got the umpire down below and the coaches out there going over the ground rules. And we'll give you the dates for the playoffs here. Concord's first round game, looks like it'll be a home game, will be Thursday, June 2nd. And assuming they finish in the top eight, which looks pretty solid at this point. Second round game will be Saturday the 4th at the home of the higher seed. So if Concord gets 4th, they'll be playing here. If not, they'll be playing, let's see, where would they be playing? They'd be playing 11-12. No, they'd be playing the 5th place team, the 4th place team, or the 3rd place team. So looking over the team scoring, Exeter and Portsmouth are both have allowed less than 30 runs and scored, I think, close to 100, if not more than 100 themselves. So if pitching wins playoffs, then they would certainly look to be some favorites. Pinkerton is always up there. They have a lot of teams have one good all-star pitcher. And it's who they have for their backup and their closer that will make a difference here. Concord's had some big bats all year long, but you got to learn to hit if you're in the playoffs. So, so anyway, a little slow getting started here. We'll go down the Concord lineup. We got Gaudreau is catching, Craig is pitching, Wachter straight up the middle here in center field, Nate Wachter. McGonigal at short, he'll be batting fourth. Reveille's out in right field, batting fifth. Fennelty is out in left field, batting sixth. Jack Reynolds at third, sixth, seventh. Dylan Miles at second, eighth, and Matt Drew over at first base, batting ninth. So we're about ready to get started here, but what seems to be the hold up here, but got the crowd still coming in, and we got a group in front of us. New Hampshire Sports Network is out in the stands and a little bit in front of us doing it. So anyway, so we're on for a 4:30 game here. Looks like we might be running a little late here. We'll check the time here. No, it's 4:32. Throw goes down to second.
Leading off for Portsmouth, the shortstop, number 3, Matt Hinkler.
Matt Hinkler leads off for Portsmouth. He's the shortstop. So Charlie Russell here as a one-man band. My color man is still unknown. Anyone wants to come on and help out, let me know. First pitch is a strike. We got a leadoff batter, a shortstop. You'd expect him to have a fairly good speed, and as a leadoff man looking to get on, get something started. Pitch outside, one ball, one strike. One pitch, looks up high, ball two. Calls time as I guess the batter steps out or asks for it. It's a 2-1 pitch. Yep, foul ball past the first base dugout. Count goes to 2-2. And the count goes full, 3-2 on the first batter. Portsmouth put up a lot of runs this year. And past the second baseman, and he knocks it down, but it trickles out to the outfield. So
adding the third baseman, number 11, Justin Blumenthal.
Not much doubt that was a hit. Blumenthal steps in. He's the third baseman. Take a peek down there, see if we get that runner on first. See if they're gonna play some small ball here. Or they're gonna be swinging away. We'll see what they're gonna do here. Foul ball back. One strike. And this is the third baseman for Portsmouth. Got some good size, like a lot of third basemen, looking to get some power out of those positions. Throw over to first. He's comfortably back. So one strike on the batter. And McGonigal starts a 6-4-3 double play.
Now batting the center fielder, number 13, Mark Lalime.
Center fielder steps in from the left side, Mark Lalime. He's the, I don't know if you can hear the field announcer here. He's the left fielder. I mean the center fielder, I'm sorry. Second baseman. There they go, 1-2-3 after the single, and we go to the bottom of the first, no score.
Leading off for Concord, the catcher, number 11, Kalen Goodrow.
Okay.
No friends in the industry, my brothers been my brothers, man.
Kalen Goodrow leads off. He's the catcher for Concord. And that was his intro music here. So we got Zingarello. Looks like he's Zingarello stands in. So obviously pitch down low. So obviously Portsmouth at 16-1 has got some pretty good pitching and some hitting as well. So we'll see what Conker can do against him today. Pitch outside, ball two. To the motion and looks in for the sign. Comes in the 2-0 pitch. Fly ball. Left fielder can't get it. And they overthrow it. And it goes to second. Left fielder went for it. He's still down.
Number one, Brooks Craig.
So we got a single with an error. Error on the, I guess that would have been the second baseman, whoever threw the ball over. So Craig stands in there. Catcher goes out and says, tries to settle down his pitcher. So Concord threatening here with Runner on second, nobody out in the first inning. Last game we did, they scored a run in inning for, I think, four or five innings in a row. Then they got two in the fifth inning. So Craig here, a good batsman, and plenty of room over there on the right side. Big hole at second base. Pitch in the outside corner, strike one. Got a little breeze blowing in here from the window. Temperature in the mid-70s. High clouds, not a lot of big shadows. High, thin clouds. Yeah. Lazy fly ball to center, not deep that enough to move anybody up.
Number 27, Nader Wachter.
Imagine he'll back up a little bit in center field with him. He's got some good power. Had a couple of doubles the last game we did, and hit a deep fly ball out there that almost to the flagpole. Stands in from the right side. Junior. Playing outside on a curve. Ball one. So Concord are the defending state champs, and looking to defend it, make it to the finals again here. Inside, drives them back. Two balls, no strikes. Wachter, number three in the order. McGonigal on deck, and a cleanup hitter. Concord looking to get that runner around. Goes to the screen. Runner goes to third. No throw, obviously. So three balls, no strikes. So wild pitch. So Concord has somebody 90 feet away with one out. So deep fly ball will get him home. A real deep fly ball while Wachter will be a get them both home. Count goes to 3-2. No, I guess now it's 3-2. No trouble seeing the scoreboard out there and keeping track of things. Try that 3-2 pitch again. Slices one. So the run comes home. Gets an RBI. Concord goes up. 1-0.
Number 8, Cam McGonigal.
So McGonigal steps in. Last game, the paper reported he hit a triple in the later stages of the game. Okay, I think he drove in an insurance run. We got Wachter over at first. Catching that outside corner. One strike. And McGonigal started that double play in the top of the first. So fielder's choice, 5-4.
Now batting the right fielder, number 13, Dan Revelise.
Dan Revelise. Revelise stands in. He's the fifth batter in the order. We got McGonigal down there at first. He got some good speed. Wouldn't be surprised to see him going. Catching that outside corner, one strike. All over to first, comfortably back. One strike on the batter. So swinging strike, strike two. Revelise is the right fielder. Nothing close going by here. Conker with one run in, runner on first, two outs. He'll be off at the crack of the bat. High outside curve, can't get him to chase. So Conker gets one, he goes down and strikes. Conker gets one, we go to the top of the second. Conker up, 1-0.
Leading off the top half of the second inning for Portsmouth, the first baseman, number 16, Colin Marshall.
So Colin Marshall leads off the top of the second for Portsmouth. Crowding that plate, catches that inside corner. One ball, one strike. All back. One ball, two strikes. Craig in the motion, and the pitch. Pitch down low. Two balls, two strikes. Down low. Count goes 3-2. To a pitch, timeout, he steps out. I'm called time pretty late there, berating the player, I guess. So we'll try that 3-2 pitch again. All back. Try that again. Get some swing in. First strikeout.
Getting the left fielder, number 20, Elliot Miles.
Elliot Miles steps in. Pitch down low, ball one. Pitch up high. Ball two. Two balls, one strike. Two, one pitch. Catches that outside corner. Two balls, two strikes. Now steps out. Steps back in. 2-2 pitch from Craig coming up. Back. Ground to the pitcher, unassisted.
Batting the catcher, number 15, Duncan Cullinan.
Here comes the number 15, the catcher, Duncan Cullinan. Long fly ball, center field. Walked her over after it, hauls it in. So they go 1-2-3 in the second. 1-0 Concord after 1.5.
Number 9, Jack Reynolds.
So we missed Fennelly there. He flew out to center field. Jack Reynolds stands in there. Ball low. Reynolds is the seventh batter in the order. Following that outside pitch, he's consistent. I saw the last game, the umpire there, and he said, well, you know, we can't hang around forever, you know. I said, well, you're consistent, ump, I'll tell you that. He was the one calling those inside pitches. This guy's an outside pitch umpire, huh? Now, Concord up 1-0 here in the second inning, bottom of the second. Zingarello out there pitching for his second inning of work for Portsmouth. High and outside, he lays off. Reynolds is patrolling third base down there for Concord. We got a 3-1 count here. Three-two count. Glad we got umpires that have to keep track of those things. Down low, so Concord has another runner here.
Now batting the second baseman, number 2, Dylan Miles.
Dylan Miles, eighth in the order. Ryan in the picture there. Reynolds down there at first. Pitching from the stretch with a runner on. Good solid hit. Midfielder. First pitch hitting.
And the first baseman, number 4, Matt Drews.
Matt Drews steps in. Number 4. Well, Concord with 2 on and 1 out here, but at the bottom of the order, ninth batter coming up. Pitch outside, ball one. From the stretch with runners on. Swinging strike, 1-1. Yeah, he goes. Tomahawk and not much luck. You can run, but you can't hide from those cell phones, folks, I'll tell you that. It's like a 2-2 pitch coming up here. Fly ball to center field. Center fielder ranging back. Yeah. Runner on second, bluffs the third, draws a throw.
Batting the catcher, number 11, Kalen Goodrow.
So Goodrow stands in. He led off the game with a single. Came around, scored the first run for Concord. Catches the strike at the knees. An excuse me swing up over the third base dugout into the stands. Guess it went down the walkway to the stands. Two strikes. Outside. One on second. Reynolds getting a good secondary lead. Be off at the crack of the bat if there's a hit. 1-2 pitch. Again. Shortstop hauls it in. We go to the third. 1-0 Concord. So top of the third here. The designated hitter, Lamper, steps in. He's the number 7 hitter. A strike on him. Down low. Here's Craig's pitch. Right, pop up. Shortstop, ranging back, left fielder comes in for it. Hauls it in. A lot of fly balls here today.
Batting the second baseman, number 14, Jake Carlisle.
Second baseman Jake Carlisle steps in. He's the number 8 hitter in the order. Gets an outside corner, one strike. High ball, right fielder, hauls it in. Well, they're hitting them, they're popping them up, hitting them in the air.
Carmine Zingarello.
Carmine Zingarello, F9. So, pitcher against pitcher here. Zingarello giving up a hit and a run in the first inning. Right down Main Street there, strike one. Has him going for that high outside pitch, follows it down the right field line. Two strikes in the batter. High pop up. Catcher coming for it. Now up on the screen here. Gives it a good chase. Goodrow, the catcher for Concord. And two strikes on Zingarello. Right down Main Street. Caught him looking. I don't know why he wouldn't swung, but. Adam Fool. So we go to the bottom of the third, Concord up 1-0. And we go to the bottom of the third, Concord will have 2-3-4 up in the batting order. It'll be Craig, Walker, and McGonigal.
Pitcher number 1, Brooks Craig.
So we go from pitcher against pitcher to end the last inning to pitcher against pitcher right here to lead off. Craig, Brooks Craig flew out to center this leadoff. in the first inning. He didn't lead off. It's number two batter. Has him ducking. Ball one. Stands in close to that plate. The 1-0 pitch from Zingarello. Pitches that outside corner. Brooks gives a look at the ump and looks away quickly. It's a 1-1 pitch. Kind of a slow roller. He might beat that out. Well, shortstop has a pretty good play on it. Almost sounded like a broken bat ground ball.
Fielder number 27, Nader Walker.
Nader Walker. He singled and he had an RBI first time around. Rifled a single down the past the first baseman. I think the wind is blowing in, yeah, flag's blowing in, so it'll be a tough haul to hit one out here today. That outside pitch. He took one of those, dumped it in the right field behind the first base in the first inning. Comes a one strike pitch. Now, jams him off the fist. Two strikes. Nothing close going by here. Down low, he lays off. There's a 1-2 pitch. Walks to the motion. Spoils that one. Well, it looked like it was destined for that outside corner and be called a strike, and he just gets a bat on it, spoils it. Count remains, one ball, two strikes. He's moving along pretty quickly here. Up high, lays off, count goes to 2-2. Good eye, good strike zone. Can't get him to chase that high pitch. A 2-2 pitch. Foul ball down past the right field stands along the first baseline. Count remains 2-2. Well, confirms the count 2-2. Way up high, 3-2. So he's gone from 0-2 to 3, worked the count to 3-2, spoiled a couple of good pitches. Keep his bat alive, so. Probably pitch number 8 here. 3, 5, 7, 8. He gets a walk. He works him. He works him.
Batting the shortstop, number 8, Cam McGonigal.
Well, McGonigal reached with a fielder's choice. Beat the throw at first. Throw over, walked her back. Good power. Pitch high and inside. Ball one. Pitching from the stretch with a runner on. Throw down to first. Runner back. Two balls, no strikes. Up high. He's always having trouble finding that strike zone. 3-0. 3-0. Hey there. Hi, Steve. Hi, Steve. 3-0 pitch coming up. It's that strike. 3-1. Looking down the sign at third. 3-1 pitch coming in. Stolen base. Stolen base. Speedy center field. The show flashes his spikes going into second. 3-2 pitch, I believe. Walker coming around. Throw coming to the plate. Tulane. Oh, he hits it over the center fielder's head. He looked like he tried to grab it. He couldn't. And it's a double and an RBI. Concord has his second run on the board here. McGonigal with a good key hit.
Adding the right fielder, number 13, Dan Revelis.
So runner on second. The stolen base paid off. Got that run around. Revelis stands in. A one out, runner on second. Pitch down low, ball one. Revelis is the right fielder. Kind of hits an excuse me that might drop in. No, right fielder claims he's got it. Ball gets loose. Traveled a little further than I thought. F9.
Batting the left fielder, number 19, A.J. Fennelly.
A.J. Fennelly steps in. Two outs, runner on second, so he'll be off the crack of the bat, anything hit. Slices one that stays fair. One comes in, he goes into second. So he goes the other way. It's a double. Concord plates the third run. Two outs, he was running on the hit.
Now batting the third baseman, number 9, Jack Reynolds.
Third baseman Reynolds steps in. He worked a walk, so all started off with Walker working an 0-2 count to ball four. Steal second. Couple of doubles, and they get two more runs. Pitch outside, ball one. I guess there is a limit to that outside pitch. High ball out to the right field. The right fielder camped under it. So Concord gets two, and we go to the fourth. 3-0 Concord. So it goes down to second. We go to the top of the fourth. Craig faced the minimum for the nine batters for the first three innings. First batter led off with a single, and he was erased in a double play. So we got the leadoff batter, who pitcher. He's the shortstop, so memory serves me well. So Concord with a 3-0 lead. Center fielder calls for it. Right fielder calls for it. I'm not able to hold on to it, so I think we'll give that a we'll give that an error in the right fielder hit his glove.
Now batting the third baseman, number 11, Justin Blumenthal.
Third baseman Blumenthal stands in. So Portsmouth threatening here with nobody out. Runner on second. Great pitching from the stretch. Short pass ball, runner moves to third. First pitch is a ball. So, 6-3, and they give up the run, 3-1. Lalime stands in.
Center fielder, number 13, Mark Lalime.
Mark Lalime stands in. He grounded out 4-3 first time around. So one out, base is empty here. One went in for Portsmouth. Pitch down low. Catches that corner. Curveball just catches, breaks in, catches that outside corner. One ball, one strike. Craig makes the catch. Pulls out those shortstop skills. P1. Catcher.
The first baseman, number 16, Colin Marshall.
Falls backwards and holds onto it. And two down, one run in for Portsmouth. The number three hitter stands in, first baseman Marshall. Pitch up high, ball one. All one strike. Down low, two balls, one strike. The plane out there buzzing. I think a 3-1. We got a plane around there buzzing around. Center fielder walk that comes in and jumps up for it. So one run on an error. We go to the bottom of the fourth. 3-1 Concord. Dylan Miles steps in, leading off the bottom of the fourth here. Concord up 3-1. Well, I guess the ump's in a hurry today. That looked pretty far out. Strike one on the batter. Although quite a few people in the whole stands didn't think so. Ball tip, strike two. And outside. Look at miles on both teams. Huh? You know it. Fool with the curveball, so brings up Matt Drews. The second looks like the second strikeout of the game. Number nine back.
The first baseman, number four, Matt Drews.
Matt Drews flew out to center field first time around. Going to get something started, get that run back. Pitch down low, ball one. One ball, one strike. Zingarello into the motion, and here's the 1-1 pitch. Looks like a shot ball. Died. Almost looked like it was a single going in the outfield, and it just died. Shortstop had to come in for it. So L6 brings up the top of the order. Goodrow, the catcher.
Now batting the catcher, number 11, Kalen Goodrow.
Kalen Goodrow. Not a lot of times you've seen catchers leading off. They're not known for their bat prowess or their speed, but exception proves the rule here. Goodrow's third time up. Pitch inside. Oh, he singled to open the game, came around, scored the first run. Actually went all the way to pitching him inside. They went to second on a throwing error, went to third on a wild pitch, and scored on Walker's single. And he scored a run. Two balls, one strike. One pitch coming in, falls it off. Count goes to 2-2. He got hit, I think. I think it was a hit batsman. I think it was a hit batsman. A little confusing here.
Elliot Miles.
So we had Mr. Miles lead off for Concord last inning, and now we have Mr. Miles leading off for Portsmouth here. Mr. Miles grounded to the pitcher last time. Long single, Walker gets over for it, throws it in, cuts it off. So nobody on.
Batting the catcher, number 15, Duncan Cullinan.
Duncan Cullinan steps in. He's the number 6 batter in the order. Another time here. What's the time? Up fly, shortstop back. Gonna go under it, hauls it in.
Batting the designated hitter, number 23, Sebastian Lampert.
DH Lampert, he flew out to left field last time around, so one on and one out. He's the number 8 hitter in the order. Steps in from the left side, as you can see. Pitch outside, ball one. And run first. Off speed pitch, one strike, one ball. Another off speed pitch. Hit the curve. One ball, two strikes. Well, just inside. Looks like that's been called a strike for quite a few others, but they're a lot closer, so We got one ball, two strikes here. I feel they'll camp under it. One against back to first, so. Lampert flies out to left the second
14,
time.
The second baseman, Jake Carlisle.
Jake Carlisle steps in. He flew out to right field his first time around, so. Two out, and the run is still on first. Runner on first is the left fielder. Oh, I don't know what we could expect for speed over there, huh? I'll keep him close. Maybe picking up signs, maybe they're going to try and steal, get him down to second here. Didn't get around on that one. Lined it just past the dugout off the fence. Got some action down there in the Portsmouth bullpen. Nothing down there for Concord. Two strikes in the batter. Carlisle is the number 8 hitter in the order. 0-2 pitch. Fly ball, right fielder. Camped under it. Hauls it in. Well, Portsmouth's leadoff batter gets stranded out there, so. F9, and we go to the bottom of the fifth. 3-1 Concord.
The pitcher, number 1, Brooks Craig.
So Craig flew out to center and grounded to short. Two prior appearances here. We're in the fifth inning. Made a good play catching that foul pop-up behind home plate. Zingarelli out there for his fifth inning and pulls it down the third baseline. Foul between the third baseman and the coach in the coaching box. One strike. Flag's pretty quiet out there. Pitch. High and outside curve, away outside. One ball, one strike. Foul pop down there. First baseman ranging over, hauls it in. Foul ball. F3.
Now batting the center fielder, number 27, Nader Walker.
So Walker singled and then took an 0-2 count. Worked a walk. Stole second and he got knocked in by McGonigal's double in the third inning. Walker with not only a good hitter, but knows his strike zone. Curveball catches that outside corner. Hey there, how you doing? One strike pitch. Outside, one ball, one strike. Zingarello to the motion. Good pitch inside at the knees. He gives it a whack at it. One ball, two strikes. Up high. Two balls, two strikes. Doesn't chase that high stuff. That's a good habit not to have. Chasing that high stuff. 2-2 pitch coming in. Yeah, he's been calling that a strike all day, so get used to it. Strikeout number 4 for Zingarello.
Number 8, Cam McGonigal.
So McGonigal long double to center, and he came around and he scored a run as well in the third inning, so. striking the batter. Down low, he lays off. The 1-1 pitch. Swinging for the downs, just a strike. One ball, two strikes. If he shortens that swing up here. Outside. 2-2. Been getting that call in that neighborhood all day. A little too far out. 2-2 pitch coming up here. Two outs, nobody on. Long fly ball deep. Left field hauls it in, and we go to the sixth, top of the sixth. 3-1 Concord.
So we're batting the pitcher, number one, number 21, Carmine Zingarello.
Zingarello. Stands in. We got pitcher against pitcher. Last time up, he went down on strike, so to end the inning. One strike. So he's number nine in the order, and 1-2 will be to follow. Down low, one ball, one strike. So Zingarello has put seven in a row down since the when Concord scored a couple in the third inning. Concord looking for 1-2-3. And he stings one out there. Makes a turn at first.
Batting the shortstop, number three, Matt Hinkler.
Hinkler stands in. He singled and he reached on an error when the right fielder had the ball go off his glove. So Portsmouth threatening with the leadoff arm runner on like it was last inning, but he got stranded there. Which is a strike. One ball, one strike. Pitching from the stretch. Curveball doesn't drop in. It's the head around on the bat, but like it was going to be an outside strike. Fouls it off over the first base dugout in the stands. We got 2-2. Portsmouth making some noise there. Diane Swan gets past the second baseman. Makes an effort for it. So two on and nobody out for Portsmouth. Brings up the third baseman.
Now batting the third baseman, number 11, Justin Blumenthal.
He's grounded to short twice. The first inning, it was a double play. In the third inning or fourth inning, it was just 6-3. So two on, nobody out. Portsmouth at 16-1 has undoubtedly come from behind in some of their games, so see if they can shut down the this pitch is a strike. See if they can shut down the rally here, or the putative rally. Craig's still out there for his sixth inning of work. Slow roll to the short, couldn't do much with it. Looked to third, and McGonigal just held on to it. We'll give him an infield hit. So, sacks are loaded with the number.
Center fielder number 13, Max Lalime.
Max Lalime stands in. So, look, it looks like they're playing in double play depth here. C&I bloop past the third baseman. So, four hits in a row, they got to run in. Score goes to 3-2.
A Batting the first baseman, number 16, Colin Marshall.
Colin Marshall stands in. He's the first baseman. He is struck out and flew out to center here. So all back, one strike. Comes a one strike pitch. Chips that one foul. A little further down to the bullpen area. Concord's right fielder retrieves it, gets it back. Two strikes in the batter. Spoils another one. Number three hitter in the order here. Big out. Need a pop up, need a strikeout. Outside, a little wide. One ball, two strikes. Can't catch that outside corner. Sacks are loaded. Gets him at first. One scores, so it's tied up now. 6-3, gets the RBI.
Now batting the left fielder, number 20, Elliot Miles.
So Miles grounded to the pitcher and singled. So one out here, scores 3-3 now. Sacks are still loaded. Like Concord's going to play the infield in, looking to cut off the run. All back, one strike. All the foul balls. Yep, the umpire gets his store of balls replenished. One ball, one strike here. All inside. Two balls, one strike. No place to put them. Oh, okay. First base is open. I'm sorry. Okay. And outside. Three balls, one strike.
That's why I need a color guy. You want to be my color guy here?
Yeah. All the way. Well, what do we got here? We got a 3-2 count here. It's a strikeout or a pop-up here. Catches that outside corner. Yeah, been calling it all day, so he gets that strikeout.
Now batting the catcher, number 15, Duncan Cullinan.
Cullinan steps in. He's popped the short and flew out the center in two prior appearances, so big batter to get out here. He's the number six batter in the order. Third ball drops in. One strike. We got playoff type ball here a week before the playoffs start. He's out. He's out. Craig picks up a cue ball that's rolling up the first base line. Doesn't grab it the first time. And then he grabs it and able to grab it and touch the base at the same time. So Concord, Portsmouth leaves two on, and we go to the bottom of the sixth, 3-3.
So we're here for the, let's put this headset on so you can hear me.
The bottom half of the sixth inning for Concord, the right fielder number 13, Dan Revelis.
Right fielder Dan Revelis leads off. He's, I think, number five in the order. Concord looking to strike back here and well, he hits a sharp line drive at the shortstop at his feet. He unable to glove it, but he picks it up.
Number 19, A.J. Fennelly.
Fennelly steps in. Fennelly is a double last time, and I guess he got an RBI, knocked in McGonigal. So, yeah, he hit that C&I double down the left field line. Runs down the line here, so two pitches, two outs.
Number 9, Jack Reynolds.
1-3, so Reynolds walked and flew out to right. See if he takes a couple pitches here and gives his pitcher a little bit of rest between the innings. Rest of his teammates. Zingarello out there for his sixth inning of work. Ball outside. So he's walked a few. Give him some rope, see what he can do here. All back, one ball, one strike. So he's the number seven in the order. Reynolds on deck. Well, Reynolds is up, Miles is on deck. Dylan Miles on deck. So a 1-1 pitch here. Low, outside, two balls, one strike. Comes a 2-1 pitch. Hauls it off his foot. Two balls, two strikes. Not something I ever wanted to do. Fortunately, I didn't progress that far in baseball to start following them off that way. So 2-2, ump takes a little walk, lets him sting in that foot go away for the batter. 2-2 pitch. Outside, doesn't get the call. We go to 3-2 on this batter. Looking, Concord needs a runner here, base runner. And a challenge him, I bet you. Little off speed, so we go to the top of the seventh. Tie score.
Amper.
7-8-9 for Portsmouth this inning. DH stands in there. Ball outside. He has flown out to left twice. Two prior appearances. No, Portsmouth starts doing some, making some noise over there on their bench. 2-0 pitch. Craig out there for his seventh inning of work. And there's another fly ball out to left. Oh, he flies out three times to left field. Not quite a sure thing, but
second baseman number 14, Jake Carlisle.
Penalty goes back and hauls it in. A ball slicing off a left-handed batter's left-handed bat is going to slice to the line. Ball back, one strike. Carlisle stands in. He's been hitting him to right field. Couple out to fly outs to right field. Digs him out at first. Third baseman lays off the ball and let's
batting the pitcher number 21, Carmine Zingarello.
Let's McGonigal put the juice on the ball and first baseman digs it out. So a good play at both ends. Zingarello has struck out, and he singled last time up. He singled up the middle there, just past the to the second base side of the bag. Walker's ranging back. He's under it, hauls it in. So we go to the bottom of the seventh, tie score. Okay. So we'll stay with it here. Concord has always had some good speedy center fielders, one of their watchwords of their team. This is Walker out there. I think he played right last year. But looking to the playoffs, actually we'll be here for senior night on the 26th, by the time you hear that, May 26th. And Concord should have a home game on June 2nd right here at Doan Diamond, if they're in the top eight, which they should finish there. And then on the 4th, they'll have a quarterfinal game, June 4th. And then on June 8th, if they're still alive, they'll be playing semifinals down in Holman Stadium at 5 and 7 o'clock. And then the finals are at Saturday the 11th at Delta Dental Stadium. So Concord looking to win six more to defend their championship, at least the last four. So they're in the playoffs, and they're probably more than likely going to be over in the top eight, so they have a first round game. Zingarello is turned on the juice. The last hit against him was Fennelly back in the third inning, so he's had 3-7. He's got 10 in a row here, so Concord's see if they can get him tying.
For Concord in the bottom half of the seventh inning, number 10, Jacob Plant.
LaPlante, I'm going to use a pinch hitter here. LaPlante steps in. Pinch hitting for Concord. Concord needs to squeeze a run around and win this game, so. That's that first pitch for a strike outside corner. Comes the pitch. Same place, maybe a little lower. Turning on 6 o'clock here. Game started at 4:30, so a pretty quick game here, moved along. No pitching changes. He gets him lunging at that outside pitch, which he's been told is, which has been being called strikes.
Number 4, Matt Drew.
That's six, strikeout number 6 for Zingarello. That's 11 in a row for him, so momentum has shifted here. Drew stands in. He's the first baseman that dug out that throw from McGonigal an inning back. Off-speed curve, two strikes. So Zingarello getting a second wind here. Hasn't allowed a hit since the third inning. So Concord looking to scratch something out here, get a run on the board. Kind of an excuse me swing. Tapper back to the pitcher. He comes in for it. 1-3.
That's the catcher, number 11, Kalen Goodrow.
Kalen Goodrow stands in. He has reached, he scored the first one of the game way back in the first. Reached on a single, moved around on a wild pitch, stolen base, wild pitch. Oh, here we are, bottom of the seventh. Curveball drops in on that outside corner, one strike. Two strikes. There's a two-strike pitch. Up high. One ball, two strikes. Concord's leadoff batter up. So we go to extra innings, 3-3. So we're here for the eighth inning. Foul ball, they're going chasing after it. First baseman way down deep in the opposing bullpen. Gets his glove on it, but it tough wind out there. It goes just goes as a long strike. And we got the number top of the order up here. Third baseman makes a stab at it, so the error. Oh, Portsmouth has their leadoff on man, E5, leadoff man on. See if they're going to play small ball or they're just going to hit away here. They got
third baseman number 11, Justin Blumenthal.
Blumenthal is 1-for-3, grounded to short twice. We'll get that man on first in the picture here, see if we're going to play some small ball or what's going on here. He's off on the first pitch to steal second. Hit and run was on. Ball went foul. Portsmouth 16-1, having lost to Timberlane from a team that's not going to make the playoffs this year. I think they lost 8-6 earlier this week or late last week. Well, pitch looked in there, but I think the ump must have called a little high. I don't know. We got one ball, one strike here. Well, go back to that outside corner. One ball, two strikes. Blumenthal at bat. Runner over at first. See if they're going to have a hit and run here. Throwing it over. They're keeping close. Craig keeping them close. Craig out there for a seventh inning. So we got a rarity. We have two pitchers going the whole inning, and we're actually here in... Foul ball, can't get to it. He caught it, might well have been a tag up, so. Well, 1-2, I think, is the account here. One ball, two strikes. Ball back, knocks the umpire's mask off, so we'll take a little walk around and let him get a little break. Catcher goes out, talks to the pitcher, gives the umpire time to catch his breath. I imagine it's not something you look forward to. You have to anticipate it. That's why you have a mask. Count remains, one ball, two strikes. There's our runner at first. I'm gonna keep him close. Nobody warming up in either the bullpen. Well, there are somebody down there in the Portsmouth bullpen. Single. Clean single, past the third baseman. First and second, nobody out here.
A And in the center fielder, number 13, Mark Max Lalime.
Lalime stands in. He singled back in the, what was that, the sixth inning when they scored a couple runs. Like a pass ball there, the runners move up. So, not calling that high strike. So, two balls, no strikes, two balls, one strike. Foul ball. Gets the tag, comes home, cuts off that go-ahead run. Fielder's choice, 1-2, 1-2, slow hopper to 3-2. Runner moves to third. Now, looks like we may be. Got the coaches out there talking to the umps. I don't know what he's talking about. Just checking on it. Confers with the other ump and no problem. So now we got a first.
Adding the first baseman, number 16, Colin Marshall.
So we got first and third here, and Concord's playing the infield in again. And wonder whether they're going to try a double steal. Wouldn't be a bad bad routine. We'll see what goes on here. Craig's still out there. Infield is in on the edge of the grass. On it goes to second. No interest in throwing anything down there. Concerned with that runner on third. So one ball. It's that strike. One ball, one strike. Pitch low. Catcher blocks it. Well, on second and third, two out, one out. Looking for a needs a strikeout here. We've got the we got the number four hitter. Drives him off the plate. We got 3-1 here. First base is open. Try that outside corner. Foul ball. Up over the first base dugout. Looks like we got a 3-2 count here. Craig looks in. Falls off another one. First baseman going after it. Can't get there. Just over the fence on the stands. It was made it to the stands. Didn't blow back. Not getting around on those pitches, but following them down that way. Oh, he is. All four. Oh, we're loading them up. Brings up Miles again. He's grounded the pitcher, singled, and struck out. Looks like we might be at the end of the rope for Craig. Craig gets a good hand. Going to change pitches here. He goes seven and a third innings. Goes out to short, and we're going to bring in McGonigal.
We got in here. That's, I think, who their sometimes reliever is, number 8. Well, we'll take a break while they change the pitches. So, Cam McGonigal has come in to bases loaded, one out situation.
Number 20, Elliot Miles.
Elliot Miles stands in. He's the left fielder. He's reached once and 3 times. Struck out the last time up. So, McGonigal looks in. There we go. Hits the batter. When the wheels fall off, they fall off fast. So hit batsman, first pitch. Puts in the go-ahead run.
Batting the catcher, number 15, Duncan Cullinan.
Cullinan has yet to reach in 4 appearances, so auspicious start for the relief pitcher. Are you going to put in a pinch runner or what? What's going on over there? No, I guess not. So anyway, number 15, Cullinan steps in. He's the catcher. Pitch inside, ball 1. So looking to get a couple outs here. Leaving loaded. So, second out at the plate here.
Batting the designated hitter, number 23, Sebastian Lampert.
5-2. Lampert steps in. He has 3 times he's flown out to left field here. We'll see what he does here. Catches that strike on the corner. Infield still in. Curveball comes in. 2 down. Two pitch, outside, can't get the call. 1 ball, 2 strikes. Well, McGonigal is as good a competitor as there is. We saw her on the hockey rinks. We'll see what he can do here. Strikes him out.
Now batting the second baseman, number 14, Jake Carlisle.
Jake Carlisle has yet to, I guess there's only, now there's 2 outs. Jake Carlisle flown out to right field twice and grounded to short. There it is. Strokes a strong single to left, gets an RBI and brings in another run. So it's 5-3 Portsmouth.
Batting the pitcher, number 21, Carmine Zingarella.
And here's the pitcher. He's 1-for-3. Looking to help himself and put this out of reach. So we got a 2-run lead. Up high, ball 1. So kind of an oddity here. We've seen a couple of high school pitches go into beyond 7 innings into the 8th inning. I wonder if we'll see. They're going to bring somebody in. I mean, Zingarello has been on a roll, put down about 13 in a row here after giving up 3 runs early. Said 3-1.
He walks him. There's the third run in this inning, and they bat it around. Concord with a.
And the shortstop, number three, Matt Hinkler.
Matt started it off this inning with a leading off with an error on the third baseman. Came around, scored the fourth run. And we put in a pinch runner there, meaning they're gonna think Gorello's out of the game, or can he re-enter? We'll find that out. Pitch inside, one strike. Well, this is the 10th man to the plate here. Two outs, sacks loaded. Outside. I think we got three runs in here, so Concord. Great play by shortstop, 6-4. But they get three runs on one, two hits, and they leave three on. So we go to the bottom of the eighth. Concord will have Craig, Walker, and McGonigal, the heart of the order, coming up. So Brooks Craig leads off after making that fine play in the field to end the top of the eighth. Portsmouth gets four runs that inning. That play at the plate, I thought they had him on two outs at the plate, and apparently he was safe on one of those plays at the plate. So ten went to bat, three outs, three left on. That meant four runs left, four scored. So Concord with a deep hole, but takes 16-1 Portsmouth to extra innings. Six to three. Craig legs it down the line.
Batting the center fielder, number 27, Nader Wachter.
Wachter, good power, good stick, but got to get some base runners here. Zingarello out there again for his eighth inning of work. Outside, ball one. It's a 1-0 pitch. Ball two. Not going to give him anything good to hit here. Walker singled, walked, and struck out. Require appearances? He gets around on it, right foul ball over the right field stands. Two balls, one strike. Single right up the middle, just past the pitcher's foot. So Concord Walker keeps it alive, brings up
number eight, Cam McGonigal.
Brings up McGonigal. He doubled and scored a run in the third inning. So that's Concord's first hit. Zingarelli had gone 4, 7, 10. 14, 15 in a row, so he's one of their aces. He was a little rocky early on, but. Good solid hit, that's two in a row, so Concord's got some life in him. Takes that first pitch over the third baseman's head, one hops the left fielder.
Batting the right fielder, number 13, Dan Revelise.
Dan Revelise steps in and still looking to get him for his first hit today, and looks like we might be changing the pitcher here, huh?
He gets a good hand. Got some Portsmouth fans as well as Concord. Well, we'll take a break as they change the pitches. So Lampert comes in, I think, from right field. The pitch, two on and one out for Concord. Zingarello went 8 1/3 innings. First pitch is a strike. Oh, third baseman, fielder's choice, 5-3, 5-4.
Batting the left fielder, number 19, A.J. Fennelly.
Double hitch, and so we got first and third with two outs here, so Concord's down their last out. Fennelly had a double in the third inning. Well, Concord down by four here in the bottom of the eighth. Looking to complete a couple runs here and keep the rally going. Two outs, two on. This pitch is a strike. Penalty is a hockey player as well, called his name quite a few times over the winter. It's one way fall down in the Concord bullpen. Two strikes. Concord down to its last strike here. Ump said he didn't go. Well, one ball, two strikes. One, two pitch. Up high, two balls, two strikes. Well, he holds the bat fairly steady, steps in from the left side. That's it. Portsmouth wins 7-3 in extra innings. So Charlie Russell for Concord TV. Thanks for watching. And if you want a copy of this game, you can get it at Concord TV, 226-8872. Thanks for watching.